Now that the state budget do-over, if you will, is done, the governor is now preparing for a second special session. This one will address expanding gaming in Maryland. It was a contentious issue during the regular General Assembly that really went nowhere. 11 News reporter David Collins joins us live now. He has details for us. David?
Rod, in this letter to State House presiding officers, the governor frames the issues that needed to be addressed before he calls another special session, and he wants answers by June 20th.
The upcoming special session, certainly we have to address the gaming issue.
Governor Martin O'Malley is preparing to call a special session on expanded gaming in Maryland, but not without some expert guidance. Last week, he wrote the State House presiding officers, advising that the Department of Legislative Services is working with PricewaterhouseCoopers. The consultant is already under contract by the Slots Location Commission. PwC is investigating the potential impact expanded gaming would have on existing facilities. The governor asked House Speaker Michael Bush and Senate President Mike Miller to support the creation of an 11-member gaming commission.
Good morning and thank you all.
To come up with recommendations based on its own research and the findings of the PwC.
Those issues are many and require some reflection and aforethought and planning.
The governor wants the gaming expansion work group to consider fair compensation for existing operators if table games are allowed, as well as if a sixth gaming site is added to the mix. The group will establish table game splits between the state, operator, and host jurisdiction. The commission will determine effective dates for table game expansion at existing sites and the potential opening of a new facility. The group will look into adjusting splits to shift gaming machine procurement responsibilities from the state to operators, and they will consider streamlining the gaming expansion application process. Organized labor supports a sixth casino location in Prince George's County. One frequently mentioned site is National Harbor. Senate Bill 892, which failed during the regular session, lets voters decide whether to allow a sixth casino location as well as existing sites to offer table games. The governor suggests that bill be used as a starting point. Senate President Mike Miller says expanded gaming will generate $300 million and could be used to chip away at the structural deficit.
We're looking for sources of revenue other than taxation. Gaming was that source.
Although no firm date has been announced for a second special session, the governor's letter indicates he would like to call one in July. Reporting live from the studio, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.